How are you all, my dear students? I hope you all are fine and doing well at home and enjoying maths. Now again, it's time for maths lecture. So let's begin. In our previous lecture, in our last lecture, we have started a new chapter. We have started a new chapter, chapter number 3, that is subtraction. We have started a new chapter, chapter number 3, subtraction. And yesterday we just revised some basic concepts of subtraction which you have learned in class 2. We just revised all the basic things which you have learned in class 2. We just revised in our last lecture. So today we will learn just new things. First of all, let us understand some subtraction properties. Subtraction properties or facts. What are the subtraction properties? Number one, whenever 0 is subtracted from a number, the difference or the result is number itself. We have learned zero property in addition also. Whenever we add 0 in any number, or 0 is added to any number, or any number is added to 0, the result will be number itself. Likewise, in subtraction also, we are having zero property. What is zero property? Zero, when 0 is subtracted from a, the result is number itself. For example, suppose you have 2 pencils. Suppose you have 2 pencils and nobody is taking any pencil from you. It means no one has pencils. Now count how many pencils you have. Initially you are having pencils and nobody is taking any of your pencils. No one is taking pencil from you, okay? It means you have 1 and 2 pencil. It means you have 1 and 2 pencil. Nobody is taking any pencil. It means 0 pencils are getting, 0 pencils are getting away from you, or nobody is taking away any pencil from you. It means 0 pencil. No pencil means 0 pencils. So all the 2 pencils are with you. Means this is how we can understand zero property. Whenever 0 is subtracted from any number, the result is number itself. Like in this case, initially you were having 2 pencils and nobody is taking any pencils from you. It means we are subtracting 0. We are taking away 0 pencils. So at last you are having 2 pencils. So 2 minus 0 is equals to 2. Likewise, we can do any, we can do it with any number. 6 minus 0. 6 minus 0. We are not taking any number away from the 6. So 6 minus 0 is 6. 10 minus 0 is 10. 100 minus 0 is 100. So whenever 0 is subtracted from any number, the number, the result will be number itself. Okay? Now the next property, which is the next property, whenever 1 is subtracted from a number, whenever 1 is subtracted from a number, the answer will be previous number or predecessor. Whenever 1 is subtracted from a number, the result or answer will be predecessor or its previous number. Suppose you are having 3 lollipops. You are having 3 lollipops. Okay? Now, your best friend is asking for 1 lollipop from you. So will you give it to your best friend? Yes, because your best friend is asking. So this 1 lollipop you are giving to your best friend. Okay, so now how many lollipops do you have now? Let's count 1 and 2. Initially you were having 1, 2 and 3 lollipops. Now your friend is taking away 1 lollipop from you. So So now you are having 1 and 2. 2 lollipops. So initially you were having 3. 1 is taken away by your friend and now you are having 2. So our answer is 2. So let's see the counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So where is the number 3? Where is the number 3? Number 3 is here. So what is the previous number of 3? The previous number of 3 is 2. So let's check when we remove 1 from the 3, what we got? We got 2 as answer. It means whenever we will subtract 1 from any number, we will get previous number or its predecessor. What is predecessor of 3? 2. So we got 2 as answer. So 4 minus 1, what will be the answer? What is the predecessor of 4? Or what is the previous number of 4? 3 is the previous number of 4. So our answer will be 3. So these were the two properties or fact of subtraction. Whenever we move, whenever we subtract 1 from any number, we get previous number or we get its predecessor. Or whenever 0 is subtracted from any number, the result will be number itself. Now let's solve some book questions. We are going to solve 3-digit addition. In class 2nd, we have done 2-digit addition. In class 2nd, we have done 2-digit subtraction. And in our last lecture also, we had this Robin the Rabbit to reach the grass by solving subtraction questions, okay? So let's see how to solve 3-digit subtraction questions. Okay, let's take an example.
946. So what we do, first of all we arrange the numbers. We always subtract smaller number from the greater number. Our bigger number is our minuend. Okay, always remember, our bigger number is our minuend. Okay, so
first of all 1, 2 and 3 we will count number of digits in both the numbers. So let's count 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2 and 3. Both the numbers are having 3 digits. 3 digits are there. It means we will write 3 places. 3 digits are there. It means we will write 3 places. Let's write 100, tens and ones. Ones, tens and hundreds. We have written 3 places. Now, the next step is finding minuend and subtrahend. So 835 and 946, which is our minuend? The bigger number. So we will write bigger number first, 946. Keep in mind 100 to hundreds, tens below tens and ones below ones. Okay, now our subtrahend is 835. Since we are doing subtraction, so we'll put minus sign. Since we are doing subtraction, so we'll put minus sign. Okay, now let's subtract. It is very simple. As we have done of 2-digit subtraction, same. What we will do, we will subtract ones from ones, tens from tens, and now we are having one more column, that is of hundreds. So we will subtract hundreds from hundreds. It is very simple. Now ones from ones. We'll subtract ones from ones. Number 6 is there. So what we'll do? We will draw 6 sticks. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll draw 6 sticks. Now, minus 5. Minus 5. Minus 5 is there. It means we'll cancel out 5 sticks. Minus 5 is there. So we will cancel out 5 sticks. Let's cancel 5 sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have cancelled out 5 sticks out of 6. Now, let's count how many sticks are left. Let us count 1. Only one stick is left, so we will write the number 1. Okay? Now, we are done with 1's column. Now, it's time for 10's column. So, let's do it. The first number is 4 there, so we will draw 4 sticks. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Minus 3. It means we will cancel out 3 sticks. So, let's cancel 1, 2 and 3. Now, let's count how many sticks are left. 1. Only 1 stick is left, so we will write 1. Okay, now the last column or 100's column, it is turned for 100's column. So the first number is 9, so we will draw 9 sticks. Okay, minus 8 is there, so we will cancel out 8 sticks. So let's cancel 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now let's count the remaining sticks. Let's count 1. Only 1 stick is left, so we will write the number 1. So our minuing was 946 and subtrahend was 835 and our difference is 111. So I hope you all understand the simple steps of doing subtraction. First of all, we'll arrange number in column wise, 100 tens in ones. We will arrange the number in their places. Then what we will do, first of all we will subtract ones from ones and we'll subtract 10 from tens and at last hundreds from 100.
This was the example. Now let's try some book questions. All of you open your notebooks, open your classwork copies. So, we are going to solve exercise 3.1. So, question number 1 is subtract the following. So, first of all, we will write exercise 3.1 in the copy at the top of, we will write exercise number is 3.1. Now, our question number 1 is subtract the following. So, let's write question also. Subtract the following. Now, part A. First of all, we will write 100 tens in ones. We will write all the places in our copy. First of all, we'll write all the places. Let's write 100 tens and ones. Okay. Now, first number is 632. So, we will write 632. Then, the second number is 431. We'll put minus sign also as we are doing subtraction. Okay. So, the drawing of sticks is our rough work. Will not show the drawing of sticks in our fair work. Okay. So, since number 2 is there, so we will draw 2 sticks. Let's draw. Now, minus 1. We'll check for the sign. Which sign is given there? Minus sign is there. So, what we will do? We will cancel out these sticks. Minus 1. So, how many sticks we will cancel out? We will cancel out 1 stick. Okay. Now, let's count how many left. Only 1 stick is left. So, we will write the number 1. Now, moving towards the 10th column. 3. First number is 3. So, we will draw 3 sticks. Minus 3, it means we'll cancel out 3 sticks. 1, 2 and 3. We had cancelled 3 sticks. Now, let's see if any stick is left.
no stick is left. No stick means number 0. So we'll write the number 0. Okay. Now the last column or hundreds column. Number 6 is there. So we will draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 sticks. Minus 4. Minus 4. It means we will cancel out 4 sticks. Let's cancel. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1 stick and 2 stick. 2 sticks are left. So we'll write the number 2. Okay, so our answer is, our difference is 201. So with the using of ruler, you will make lines. Ma'am is doing by running hand, but you have to use ruler or scale. Okay, do not make this line by running hand. You have to make all the lines by using ruler or scale. Okay, now we are done with part A. Let's do part B. Again, in the copy, first of all, we will write all the places. We will write all the places, 100, tens and ones. Okay? Now, first number given there is 271. So, we will write 271. Now, the next number is 271. The next number is 130. So, 130. Again, write ones below ones and tens below tens. Okay? Now, minus sign is there. So, we will also put minus sign. Now, 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0. Remember, we just learned the properties. Whenever 1 is subtracted from any number, the result will be number itself. So here, 0 is getting subtracted from 1, so our result will be 1. 7 minus 3. Now, tens column, 7 minus 3. So let's draw 7 sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay? Minus 3. So we will cancel out 3 sticks. Let's cancel 1, 2, and 3. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sticks are left. So we will write the number 4. Now, hundreds column. 2. Number 2 is there. So we will draw 2 sticks minus 1. Minus 1. It means we will cancel 1 stick. Now let's count 1. 1 stick is remaining. So we will write the number 1. So, our difference is 141. Now, moving toward next part. One more thing. Once again, we'll make proper lines with the help of scale or ruler in copy, okay? And the drawing of mistakes is a rough work, so we'll not show it in fair, okay? Part C is 698. We'll write ones below ones, tens below tens, and hundreds below hundreds. 698 minus 473. Minus 473. Now, 8 minus 3. So we will draw 8 sticks for it. I'm rubbing the question and we'll draw sticks here, okay? 8 minus 3. So we will draw 8 sticks first. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 3. So we will cancel out 3 sticks. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 sticks are left, so we will write the number 5. Now 9 minus 7. So first of all, we will draw 9 sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Minus 7. So we will cancel out 7 sticks. Let's cancel 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we will count the number of sticks left. Let's count 1 and 2. 2 sticks are left, so we will write the number 2. Now the last 6 minus 4. So we'll draw first of all 6 sticks. Minus 4. Let's cancel 4 sticks. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1 and 2. 2 sticks are left, so we will write the number 2. So our answer or difference is 225. Now the next part. I hope you all are doing with me in your copy also, okay? If you are not able to do note down with me, you can pause the video or take a screenshot and write later. As I am providing PDF of all the notes also, so you can write from the notes also, okay? Now, part B. 578. Our minuend is 578 and subtrahend is 463. Now we'll start always from 1. So 8 minus 3. So we will draw 8 sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 3. Minus 3 is there. So let's cancel 1, 2, and 3 sticks. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 sticks are left. So we will write the number 5. Now 7 minus 6. So first of all, we will draw 7 sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Minus 6. Minus 6 means we will cancel out 6 sticks. So let's cancel 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1. 1 stick is left, so we will write the number 1. Okay? Now the last column, 5 minus 4. So we will draw 5 sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Minus 4. Minus 4 is there. So we will cancel out 4 sticks. Let's cancel 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we'll count how many sticks are left. Let's count 1. 1 stick is left, so we will write the number 1. So our answer is 115. Okay? Now the next one. The next one is part E. Two hundred eighty-five minus one hundred fifty-two. Now 5 minus 2. We'll always start from the ones. So 5 minus 2. So let's draw 5 sticks minus 2. So we will cancel out 2 sticks. So let's cancel. Now we will count the number of sticks left. How many left? 1, 2 and 3. 3 sticks are left. So let's write the number 3. Now it's turn for tens column. 8 minus 5. 8 minus 5. So we will write the sticks first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. minus 5. Minus 5 means we will cancel out 5 is 6. So let's cancel. Let's cancel 5 is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1, 2 and 3. 3 sticks are left. So we will write the number 3. Okay. And the last column, which is of hundreds, 2 minus 1. So we will draw 2 sticks minus 1, which means we will cancel 1 stick. Now let's see how many sticks are left. 1 stick is left, so we will write the number 1. So our answer is 133. Our answer is 133. Now I hope you all are noting down with me. Okay, we remember write hundreds below hundred, tens below tens and ones below ones. And the drawing of the sticks are our rough one. This drawing of the sticks is for our convenience, so we will not draw them in our fair work, okay? 7 minus 1. So we will draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. We'll draw 7 sticks for the 7 minus 1. Minus 1 means we will cancel 1 stick. So we had cancelled 1 stick. Now let's count how many sticks are left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 sticks are left, so we'll write the number 6. Now 9 minus 8. So we'll draw 9 sticks first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Minus 8. Minus 8 is there, so we'll cancel out 8 sticks. Let's cancel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now let's see how many sticks are left. Only 1 stick is left, so we will write the number 1. Now the last one, 3 minus 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 sticks for the number 3. Minus 3. It means we cancel all the 3 sticks. Now is any stick left? No stick is left. No sticks means no number 0. No sticks means the number 0. So we'll write the number 0. And our answer is 16. Okay? 1, 6, 16. So, this is how we can do 3-digit subtraction. First of all, we will write all the places. Then, we will write number properly. 100 below 100, tens below tens and ones below ones. Then, we will subtract. We always start from the rightmost position. We always start from rightmost position, which is ones. So any of the operation, whether it is addition or subtraction, will always start from ones. So first of all, we will subtract ones from ones, then we will subtract tens from tens, and then at last we'll subtract hundreds from hundred. So we did 3-digit addition of 2 numbers. This is how we can do it. Okay. So this is all for today's lecture. We will meet in next lecture and complete exercise 3.1. We'll meet in the next lecture and we'll complete exercise 3.1. Till then, bye bye students. Stay home, stay safe and keep practicing. Bye bye.